Good morning, children. Once again, welcome to online class. So we have started with the second lesson, that is microorganisms, primate 4. So I told you all that yesterday about the microorganisms, where they are present, how they are useful. So useful only, I am to continue. So friendly organisms. We are talking about the friendly organisms. So yesterday I told you they are used in the preparation of curd and bakery items like bread, cake and all. So microorganisms are very useful in one way, they are very harmful in other way also. So yesterday I told that, once again I want to just recall that it is used in the, so one thing, your mom prepares the idli, dosa, batter. If you are South Indian, we prefer the tiffins like idli and dosa. You know that that batter is prepared previous day evening itself to get it fermented. So that process is called as fermentation. So next day morning you prepare the tiffins. The batter has to be prepared previous day evening itself. So the next day morning we have to prepare the tiffin, because that batter has to be fermented. This fermented is nothing but the yeast, the bacteria which are involved in the batter, it leads to the fermentation. So due to that fermentation, there will be rise in the volume of the batter. So it the taste will be a little bit changed, and it converts into sour also. So that batter has to be prepared for tiffins and all. So like that, even this, in this process also it is very useful. And one more thing, I told you to convert the milk into curd. So you have you seen, most of the children have seen their moms will prepare the curd. How they prepare? They'll take the milk, one bowl of milk, and they'll boil it for some extent like lukewarm, plus they'll add some pinch of curd to it. So if you preserve it for 7 to 8 hours, then the whole milk will be converted into curd. So how it is that? The curd, there is one bacteria by name lactobacillus which is present in the curd, that converts whole milk into the curd. So this is also useful microorganisms. So till now I have told this. So now today I am going to teach about the commercial use of microorganisms. Commercial use of microorganisms. So if you talk about the wine production, so you know that wine production is done by the fruits like grapes, crush, or some other acidic formations like acetic alcohol and formation of some other things. So these are also the conversion of sugar into alcohols. For example, I'll tell you one thing. Take a beaker filled with the 3/4 of water. Okay, 3/4 of water. Take a beaker filled with the 3/4 of water of that beaker. Add a sugar to it and stir it. Add 2 tablespoons of sugar to it and stir it. And next you add yeast to it. Okay, yeast to it. So leave it for some hours. And after that you just observe the solution and smell it. Okay, so you get some stinging smell. Stinging smell is nothing but the smell of alcohol. It is the smell of alcohol, as sugar will be converted into alcohol because the presence of bacteria, what is that? Yeast. So the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is nothing but the fermentation. What it is called as fermentation. It is called fermentation. Okay. So this is one thing of commercial use of microorganisms. So it is used in the some other large scale production or industries also, like wine preparation and all. So this is also one use of commercial use of microorganisms. Next comes medicinal use. Medicinal use of microorganisms. medicinal use of organisms. Okay, children. When you fall sick, you will go to the doctor, isn't it? When you fall sick, you will go to the doctor and they will give some antibiotics, okay, to stop that diseases. So antibiotics are nothing but the injections which are given to stop the diseases which are caused by the microorganisms. So antibiotics are nothing but the injections. It is in the form of injections like cytotoxin and tetracycline and one more erythromycin. So these are the some antibiotics injections which are given to the infected person to stop the disease which are caused by the microorganisms. So this antibiotics was introduced by the scientist called Alexander Fleming. So he was the first person to introduce the antibiotic, and the name of first antibiotic was penicillin injection. So this was the first antibiotic injection which was introduced by the Alexander Fleming. So these are some antibiotics are like streptomycin. Okay, tetracycline, and one more is erythromycin. So these are the name of the antibiotics. These are the names of antibiotics which are introduced, okay, so given to the bodies for infected person. So these antibiotics which are made from fungi and bacteria, they stop the microorganisms which leads to the further diseases. When you inject the person with these antibiotics, it will be having fungi and bacteria. It stops the microorganisms which produces the diseases. So antibiotics are manufactured by sowing some specific microorganisms which is used to cure and variety of diseases. Okay. And next thing is vaccine. What do you mean by vaccine? Vaccine is nothing but the treatment, okay, given to the particular diseases. This is called vaccine. See, when the person is having some diseases, okay, the body produces antibodies. Antibodies is nothing but the which are produced by the bacteria. Those antibodies are again injected by the giving some particular medicine. Okay, those antibodies which enters the healthy person, it will be, they fight with the against the microbe by giving some medicines. So after that, Edward Jenner was the first person to find the vaccine. He found the vaccine for the polio and other some chicken pox and all. So polio is also done in the mass group, like given to the every child within the 5 years. So polio drops are given to all the child within the 5 years. So worldwide campaign against the polio is also done in the various cities and towns and all to give in the mass number. Okay, these days vaccines are made on large scale. So from microorganisms to protect humans and other animals from several diseases. So this is called vaccine. Okay, I hope you have understood the commercial use of microorganism and medicinal use of microorganisms and even the vaccine.